Hello, I am Luis Nuño. I am a professor in the area of signal theory and communications at the Polytechnic University of Valencia in Spain. Now I am going to explain one of the applications of the harmonic wheel in harmony and composition, which is the modulation and pivot chords. Modulation consists in changing from one key to another. It is used in music to avoid monotony and to increase variety. There are several kinds of modulation. The diatonic modulation consists in using first a pivot chord, which is a chord belonging to both keys, that is the first key and initial key and the final key, and then to include a cadence to affirm the new key. The cadence can be a chord progression such that subdominant chord, dominant seventh, tonic, or for example second degree minor, dominant seventh, tonic, or other similar chord progressions. The pivot chords can be obtained with the harmonic wheel, as well as in the traditional way. We will compare both ways. For simplicity, we will consider only consonant pivot chords, that is, major and minor chords. We should remind that every major or natural minor key contains six consonant chords, three major and three minor. Here we have represented the C major key on the harmonic wheel. We should remind that the tonic is inside a small rectangle and the other notes of the scale are inside circles. We have not represented the other notes outside this big curved rectangle. Inside this blue rectangle, we have the six consonant chords associated to the C major key. The three major chords, C, F, G, and the three minor chords, D minor, A minor, E minor. If we want to modulate from C major to G major, for example, we can use the traditional or common procedure, which consists in first writing the C major scale and then to add 2/3 on every note, thus obtaining the triad chords in C major. Then we write the G major scale, but starting with note C in order to compare with the previous scale. So we write C, D, E, F sharp, G, A, B, and then we add 2/3 on every note, thus obtaining the triad chords in G major. Now we have to see which of these chords are common to the two keys. We can verify that there are four common chords or four pivot chords, which are C major, E minor, G major, and A minor. We can obtain these four chords with the harmonic wheel in a very direct way. For example, here we have the C major key. The tonic is C inside this little rectangle. And we can observe that the G, note G, is one step to the right of C. So if chords in C major are from here to here in this region, the chords belonging to G major will be from here to here, as we can see in this figure. Let's see again, this is the C major key containing these six consonant chords, and this is the G major key containing these six consonant chords. So the chords belonging to both keys are A minor, C major, E minor, G major. We can now modulate, for example, from C major to D major. With the common procedure, we write the C major scale and then we add 2/3 on every note, thus obtaining the triad chords. For D major, we write the major scale starting with note C, in this case C sharp, D, E, F sharp, G, A, and B, and then we add 2/3 on every note. Now we have to see which of these chords are common to the two keys. We can see that they are only two chords, E minor and G major. If we use the harmonic wheel, here we have the C major scale, which consonant chords are inside this blue rectangle. And we can observe that the tonic D is here, that is two steps to the right of note C. So the chords belonging to D major are these six chords. So only these two chords, E minor and G major, belong to both keys. With a harmonic wheel, we can see that if we want to modulate from C major to A major, for example, there are no consonant pivot chords between these two keys. If we want to modulate to the region of flats, that is, for example, from C major to F major, here we have the C major key and the F tonic, the F note is one step to the left of C. So the six consonant chords belonging to F major are these. We can see it again, these are the six consonant chords belonging to C major key, and these are the six consonant chords belonging to F major. So the chords which are common to both keys are D minor, F major, A minor, and C major. If we want to modulate from C major to B flat major, we can observe that here we have the tonic C and here we have the tonic B flat, that is two steps to the left of C. So the chords belonging to the B flat major are these ones. Only the two chords D minor and F major belong to both keys. We can now consider a more difficult example to modulate from D flat major to B major. In this case, if we use the common procedure, it is very difficult to find the common chords because D major has five flats in the key signature and B major has five sharps in the key signature. So here it's not easy to see which are the common chords. And we have to use, of course, enharmonic notes. On the contrary, if we use the harmonic wheel, we can see here the tonic D flat with these consonant chords. And here we can see the B, the tonic B with these six chords. So here we can directly see that the chords common to both keys are D sharp minor and F sharp major, or the enharmonic chords E flat minor and G flat major. As conclusions, I explain the diatonic modulation, which consists in using a pivot chord, which is a chord common to the two keys, the initial key and the final key, and then to include a cadence. With a harmonic wheel, we can obtain in a direct way all the consonant pivot chords, that is, chords belonging to both keys. We also shown that if two keys differ in more than two accidentals, for example, from C major to A major, there is no consonant pivot chord among these two, between these two keys. In these cases, we have to use other methods for modulate. For example, we can use the Neapolitan sixth chord, alto scales, dissonant chords, deceptive cadences, etc. And of course, we can use other kinds of modulations apart from the diatonic, which are chromatic and enharmonic modulation. The harmonic wheel gives us all the 12 major and minor scales, as well as a panoramic view of all the relationships among all the keys. So it is a very useful tool for studying the modulation. You can find all the information on the webpage harmonicwheel.com. Thank you very much for your attention.